the 40 for Rochester. Here's the pitch to Beck. Beck with blockers in front. Beck runs over a tackler and it's a first down. He's still on his feet. Beck at the 20, the 15, the 10, the 5. Touchdown! The ball's not yellow with red stitches. I don't know anything about anything.
Okay.
So I found it interesting, and he was just kind of talking about where to hit the ball and what happens if you see too much spin or not enough spin, and it was really pretty interesting, and it made a lot of sense to me. So I'll share that with you here later on in the broadcast.
All right. Look forward to it.
I'm sure you are on the edge of your seat.
I will be going home right after this game
and practicing. Be sure to stretch first because you'll pull a hamstring.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. Yeah, I'll have to. I'll have to put my ankle knee brace on probably before I start.
Probably.
I'll go home and practice on Madden.
And go ahead and get your ice bath ready.
Yeah, exactly.
So the Rochester Zebras
are going to receive the football.
Are going to receive the football, and they will go to our left. Wind out of the north, northeast right now here at Rochester High School, about 72 degrees under a cloudy sky.
Beautiful football weather tonight.
Hey, boy. Odin Yeadon, a junior for the Wabash Apaches, will kick off for Rochester. Brett Abbott, Jay Heckathorn, and Jacob Houdeshell left to right. The deepest man is Heckathorn. He stands inside his 15 at about the 13-yard line. The other two backs, Abbott and Houdeshell, at the 20. We are ready to go. Week number 3 of the high school football season here in the TRC is underway. Yeadon, high end over end kick. Heckathorn takes it at the 9. At the 15, the 20. Steps away from one tackler, but not the rest of them as he's brought down about the 21 or 22. And I think on the return, we're going to have a block in the back as well.
Well, that's not a good start for the Zebras.
Mm-mm.
They get the ball, which in amongst itself is kind of an unusual thing. Rochester usually would defer if they won the toss. So I'm not sure Wabash either electing not to take the football or.
Oh, really?
Yeah, okay. On Wabash.
Going against Wabash.
Did you see the block in the back?
I did see the block in the back.
Yeah.
I just don't know if the refs did.
So it's going to be whistled against the Apaches, and it's going to now place the ball outside the 25 at about the 26-yard line on the far hash, and Rochester will be going to our left. Brad Thomas, Travis Watering, I'm David Musselman. First game of the conference, third game of the regular season. John Hunting, quarterback for the Rochester Zebras, brings the group to the line of scrimmage. They have two receivers on the near side. That's Bennett and Heckathorn. I-back formation of Beck and Houdeshell. Hunting under center. Takes a snap. Gives to Houdeshell up the middle. Jacob Houdeshell right up the middle. Dragging a couple of Apache tacklers with him. Gets it out to the 36-yard line. He's going to be shy of a first down of about a yard. It'll be second and one. Nice block up front by the fellas. So it'll be second down and one after a 9-yard gain by Jacob Houdeshell. 30 seconds gone here in this opening quarter. Bennett and Heckathorn wide to the near side. Ball in the middle of the field. Again, Zebras going to our left. Houdeshell dots the I. West Beck right up the middle, stood up the line of scrimmage, twisting his way across the line to gain. Give him two. It'll be first and 10 for the Z's.
West Beck hit behind the line of scrimmage, but just his sheer strength and size, he's able to push forward about a yard and fall forward for the second yard.
I'm looking at Gavin Bennett when he comes wide to our side. The defensive back on him right now is 5'9". I wonder if we'll see any action to him tonight or today.
So it'll be first and 10 for the Z's at their own 37-yard line. Ball in the middle of the field. Bennett wide to the near side. Two flankers for Rochester. Heckathorn to the left. Houdeshell to the right. Houdeshell comes in motion to the near side. Gets the carry on the jet sweep. Coming to the near side. Has a great blocker and Shane in front of him. There's a flag on the play for a hold. Heckathorn carries it out to midfield. That's a plenty for a first down, but there will be a hold on the play.
Looked like maybe Houdeshell had a hold.
Well, I couldn't. I think it was Shane. I think it was Shane.
Okay.
And you can't wrap and call it a block, right? I mean, that's called usually a
tackle. Yeah. And there's two flags out there, so more than
us saw it. Yeah, same two saw what we saw. So the flag was thrown at the 39-yard line. So it'll back them up 10 from there, I believe. So what would that bring up, about first and 18-ish?
That's never what you want to start the game. Two penalties in under a minute.
Well, at least the first one was 4 for the Zebras.
Right, right.
So first down and 20 for the Z's on the ball on their own 28, going to our left, ball in the near hash. Hadashell comes in motion to the near side. On the end around, Wabash blows up the play at the line of scrimmage. Hunting and Heckathorn run into each other, then Wabash drives Heckathorn inside the 15-yard line, but forward progress was stopped, thankfully, at the 26. So it'll be second and 22.
That was a blow up from the word go.
Wow.
I thought about four zebras hit each other there.
Well, Coach Zahner won't be happy with the line play on that particular
one. No, he won't.
So it'll be second and 22. Ball at the Rochester 26-yard line with 10:15 to play in the first quarter.
We may see your matchup with Bennett and that 5'9 corner.
I think it's time.
Split to the right.
There
Hunting goes back to pass. Looks right. Throws right. Looking for a receiver. It is complete to Bennett. Bennett gives a stiff arm at the 40. Falls inside the 42, giving the 44. It'll be a pickup of about 18 yards. It'll bring up third and about three for the Zebras.
If Wabash doesn't make any adjustments to that, they can hit Bennett all night today.
All night.
Well, and you know what? Hunnick had a lot of time to stand back there and look for him.
And even against Plymouth, that slant route they ran every time the Zebras was open.
Yeah.
So it'll be third and three for the Rochester Zebras with 9:35 to play in the first quarter. Bennett comes split to the near side, which is the wide side of the field. I-backs for Hunting. Heckathorn, the flanker to the left. John Hunting under center on third and three. Flips it out to Hadashell. Has a blocker to Westbeck in front of him. Looks to outrun the defense. Does side to the corner. Hadashell down the near sideline. Spins his way inside the 40. First and 10 for the Zebras.
Now, Hadashell did a good job. He got a block on the corner from Westbeck, and he was able to get that ball out to the sideline before he was pushed out of bounds.
That's a good job by the pulling guard, too. I think it was Connor McLaughlin from right to left, and he was in front of Hadashell the entire way.
Give him the 39-yard line. Now ball in Wabash territory. The Zebras with first and 10 on the near hash. Bennett wide to the near side. Split backs now for Heckathorn. Make that for Hunting. And Heckathorn, this flanker to the left. Beck, right side, right up the middle. West Beck carries some tacklers to the 35-yard line, give him four. It'll be a second down and six for the Zebras with just under 9 minutes to play here at Rochester High School. No score here early in this football game. Brad Thomas, Travis Watring, I'm David Musselman. Again, we were one of 73 games last night postponed because of the weather. The closest one to us, Western Taylor.
They played?
Did they get the whole thing in?
It didn't say that. I can't imagine that happening.
Yeah.
Two wideouts for Rochester on second and six. Hadashell right side, Westbeck in front of him, and he is cut down after a yard or two gain. Not a lot there. Wabash doing a great job up front, just blowing up our line.
Yeah, absolutely. They, like we said earlier, they only have one guy going both ways, so it looks like they're going to be getting nice rest when their offense does come on the field. So that's always a positive you have when you only have one guy going both ways instead of eight like Rochester.
After a three-yard gain, it'll bring up third and three for the Z's. 8 minutes to play in the first quarter. Again, Rochester going to our left. Bennett will go split to the right side, which is the wide side of the field. I-backs for the Zebras. Make that split backs for the Zebras. Shane tight end to the right. Heckathorn in motion going right. Gets the pitch going right. And gets a great kick out block by Hadashell. Kicks back inside. Carries it inside the 25-yard line. Down to around the 22. A great individual effort and a great kick-out block by Hadashell sprung Heckathorn for a first down. That was the neat part about that was Heckathorn ran by Hadashell, saw that he was going to be tackled, cut back inside of Hadashell, and in the meantime, Hadashell picked up that block and sprung him for another 10 yards.
Yep, and Hadashell did a good job of making sure that he used his shoulders and his head to get in front of that block and not get the block in the back.
That's what you get when you have veteran running backs back there. Hadashell's been running for 3 years, and Heckathorn's been out there for two or three as well.
First and 10 for the Z's at the 20 of Wabash. On the pitch, Hadashell goes to the left, cuts back in inside, carries the ball inside the 20. Boy, there was just not a lot there. Maybe the 17, give him three. Wabash doing a great job up front. You know, we've talked already so many times this year about yards after contact for Hadashell, and Wabash not allowing that. I mean, first contact, he's usually coming down today.
Right. If one guy's hitting him, you've got two more right there to help.
Their line is doing a great job of getting in our backfield.
Second down and a long seven for Rochester. Heckathorn is split to the right side. Bennett comes wide to the near side. Tied in right is Shane with Hunting under center. On second and seven, Beck goes right. Beck has it. Oh, and he's cut down by the shoestrings. And he was on his way to the end zone in a great individual effort on that far side
Chase
by
Deering,
Wabash.
The quarterback. cuts him down.
Their safety as well on defense. He came in on a blitz, it almost looked like, and his saving touchdown play.
That was the only one there was saving because he was on the way to the house, and he is cut down inside the 15 at about the 13-yard line after a pickup of about four. It'll be third and three for the Z's. They'll go to a straight T backfield, two tight ends, hunting on the center, third and three. Here's a snap. Hadashell goes left. He's hitting the backfield. He's going to be dropped.
Well, just again, once a great job by the Wabash center of their defensive line, just exploding Rochester's middle three and bringing up fourth down for the Zebras as they lose three on that one.
I mean, the Wabash, they are showing a little blitz every now and then, but the Zebra offensive line has to do a better job than that. They're not giving Hadashell, Heckerthorn, hunting any time back there.
Is this one a no-brainer? On fourth and seven.
Throw it.
Touchdown pass to Bennett.
Well, Bennett in the corner.
I think you're going to get a Bennett. He goes split to the right side.
Heckerthorn on the left. So.
And it's 5-8 defensive back on him.
And we're going to have a false start on West Beck, so it's going to back him up five more. So that'll be fourth and about 12.
You know, and he wasn't going to Bennett there. He was going out to his left side to hit Heckerthorn, it looked like, yeah.
Well, if you can get Heckerthorn one-on-one against the corner and slant him across the middle in front of the safety, that's almost as good as throwing an alley-oop to Bennett in the back.
Well, now scooting back 5 yards, it might be that
Now I think you bring Bennett back into the play.
I agree.
It's fourth and 12 now for the Zebras.
What are they, 22-yard line?
At the 22 or 3. Splitbacks for Hunting. Bennett wide to the right side. There's the target. Bennett looking to the end zone. Going to the end zone. We're going to have an incomplete pass and no flag.
Wow.
Bennett was going to catch that ball and score.
Why not?
But he was bodied up down there by the
Should
Apaches
have been interference.
That threw him off his course.
Yep.
And no flag. So it'll be first and 10 for the Apaches at their own 22-yard line.
He ran right into him at about the 3-yard line.
And you can tell three officials are right there as well.
Yeah.
So Wabash will take over on downs. After a couple of penalties, Rochester shoots themselves in the foot. It'll be first and 10 for the Wabash Apaches at their own 22. Derrick comes to the line of scrimmage. He's in the shotgun formation. Three receivers, two left, one to the near side. Back to pass is Derrick. Throws down the middle of the field. It's incomplete and behind the intended receiver, Vest. And that'll bring up second down and 10 for the Apaches with 5:17 to play in the first quarter. Quickly on the ball are the Apaches. Two receivers on the near side, two to the far. And Chase Derrick, the senior quarterback in the shotgun formation. It looks like with Proctor to his left. Out of the shotgun, here's the snap on the option. Chase Derrick keeps it right up the middle and is tackled at the 31, 32-yard line. He's going to be close to an Apache first down.
Heckerthorn on the tackle for Rochester.
I like what Chase Derrick does back there. He had the ball in his running back's hands and literally took it right back out when he saw he had a better option than handing it off.
Give him 11 on the carry. It'll be first and 10 for the Wabash Apaches at their own 33-yard line. Grant Derrick now takes it left on the jet sweep. Grant Derrick lowers his head, pushes the pile forward to about the 40-yard line. So he's going to pick up about 7 yards. It'll bring up third and make that second and three for the Apaches. Quickly on the ball is Wabash. Proctor to the right of Derrick. Chase Derrick is in the shotgun formation. Three receivers on the near side. Ball in the far hash. Chase Derrick under center. In the shotgun. Keeps it again right up the middle. He is met, but not before he gets the first down as he pushes the pile ahead about the 45-yard line, giving five on the pickup. It'll be another first down for the Apaches.
This is what I think Coach Zahner is a little nervous about, the Zebra defense coming out flat like they are right now. Wabash is doing whatever they
want.
They're
getting lit up.
And it seems like the front of our defensive line is the weakest point, right? But right up the middle of it.
Well, we saw that last week, didn't we?
Yeah, we did.
As Zahner said in his pregame, the battle has to be won up front.
First and 10 for Wabash. Vest comes in motion to the near side. Derrick back to pass, complete to Vest. He is hit immediately
by Hadashell.
As he cuts him down at about the 48-yard line, giving 3, 2, and 7 for the Apaches. With 4 minutes to play in the first quarter, no score yet here at Rochester High School. Giving the 49. Ball in the near hash. Wabash going to our right on the no-huddle offense. Chase Derrick has the play. Vest and Cole wide to the near side. Dillon is split left. Proctor is left of Chase Deering, the quarterback, with 10 on the play clock. From the shotgun, gives to Proctor. Proctor eludes a couple of tacklers, gets it into Rochester territory at the 49, giving two. It'll bring up third down and about four. 3:25 to play in the first quarter.
Wilson Lee on the tackle for the Zebras.
Third and four for Wabash at the Rochester 49-yard line with 3:05 to play in the first quarter. Chase Deering from the shotgun on the option going left. Now flips it out to Proctor. Proctor is hit and dropped in the backfield. He's going to lose about 5 yards. It'll be fourth down and about eight.
Heckathorn on the top stop for the Zebras.
Deerdag would have been better off just taking the hit himself.
Yep.
There.
Yeah.
He had a chance of, it looked like he bobbled the pitch anyway, and he got just drilled in the backfield.
Fourth and eight for the Apaches, and on comes the punting unit.
Well, Heckathorn was coming right for Deering, and he made the decision to pitch it. Heckathorn didn't even hesitate. He went right past him and right into
Proctor.
He didn't
care who had the ball.
No.
Heckathorn stands inside this 20, an option play on the punt. Nice high kick for Wabash. The wind's going to affect a little bit. And there's a muff. Ball's loose. Wabash is going to pick it up. Right through the hands of Heckathorn. Wabash right there. Johnny on the spot to recover the football at the 22-yard line of the Zebras.
That's just one of those Saturday afternoon brain cramps.
Just focus.
He's waving it off and staring at the football, but he's got a Wabash defender 2 yards staring him down, and he took his eyes off the ball.
You got a wind about 10 or 12 miles per hour, too, which affected it.
Okay, how close can the Wabash just not touch him?
I think it's a yard at the halo. Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah.
So Wabash first and 10 at the Zebra 22-yard line. Deering back to pass. Little wide receiver screen goes out to Dillon, and it is complete, but for very little, if
maybe
any.
Maybe a yard?
Maybe. Ben Dillon, junior receiver on that far side. I think the play was there if they could have got him the football, but he had to go down and pick it up. They're going to say it's a catch, however, zero on the gain. Second down and 10 on the ball of the Apaches. Three receivers to the near side, which is the wide side of the field. Proctor to the left of Chase Deering with under 2 minutes to play in the first quarter. Deering looking at the sideline with 13 on the play clock. Now the snap. Proctor has it up the middle. Proctor, a spin move at the line of scrimmage. Now kicks it back outside and is ripped down before he gets to the 15, giving the 16-yard line. It'll be third down and about to two or three for the Apaches.
Good job by Jordan Schaefer there. I mean, it wasn't anything to do with the play, but he followed Deerdeck no matter where he went there and drilled him at the end of the play.
Yeah.
And that's what we talked about earlier about assignments. They just have to focus on their assignments. That's how they'll be successful.
Third and three for Wabash. At the 16-yard line of the Zebras, Chase Deering from the shotgun formation. Proctor to his left. Hands it off to Proctor again, left side. Proctor has a first down as he carries the ball to the 9. Give him 7. It'll be first and goal for the Wabash Apaches with a minute 10 to play in the first quarter.
So do you think Wabash watched any of that Plymouth game film from last week?
I would say they watched every second of it.
Twice, maybe.
Because I'm seeing a lot of the same scenario that we saw last week, and that's 6-7 yards right up the number 1 and number 2 gap.
Wabash has three receivers wide to the right side, which is a wide side of the field. Split left is Dillon. Out of the shotgun again is Deering with under a minute to play in the first quarter. First and goal from the 9. Deering back to pass. Looks right. Throws right. As he's getting hit, throws in the back of the end zone. It is incomplete. Had a call in the back of the end zone. Great job by Bennett.
I'm going to say that's kind of a difficult pass to have to throw over the top of Bennett.
Yeah.
Gavin Bennett, what, 6'3" for the Rochester Zebras
and
playing?
And Dillon is, that says 6 foot.
No.
No.
No, he's more than about 5 inches shorter than Bennett.
They used to give me 6 foot too, so he might be 5'10".
I would have loved that. You know,
I begged for it, though.
Yeah, I'm sure you did. Second and goal from the 9. 50 seconds to play in the first quarter. No score here at Rochester. Wabash threatening. Chase Deering, the quarterback, keeps it. Takes it up the field, gets to the 5, giving 4. It'll be third and goal from the 4 with 40 seconds to play in the opening quarter. Very quick first quarter here at Rochester. Rochester, I make that to Wabash and no huddle. They have a third and goal from the 5-yard line with under 30 seconds to play in the first quarter. We're down to 17 on the play clock. Deering now has the play, relays it. Now everybody kind of in tight here with 10 on the play clock from the shotgun. Chase Deering back to pass. Looks right, steps up, throws it in the middle of the field, had a receiver in the end zone, threw his hands, incomplete, and I believe that was intended for Noah Cole.
Deering trying to keep the ball low. He had a receiver one step across the goal line.
It was a great throw.
And three defenders around him. I think he had a lane. He was just trying to keep it low and away from the defenders, and it hit between the knees or between the feet of the receiver.
Wabash will try for a field goal. This will be spotted at the 11, so this will be a 21-yard attempt. High snap. Snap is down. It's blocked. Rochester blocks it. Hunting picks it up. He's down the far sideline. He's got blockers in front of him, and is tackled at the 24. First and 10 for the Zebras after the blocked field goal attempt.
Blocked by Jay Heckethorne.
So nice job by Rochester's defense when they get backed up against their own goal line. They managed to stop Wabash's rushing attack and then get the block on the field goal to set themselves up first and goal outside of the 20, or first down outside of the 20-yard line.
You know, that play, Wabash lucky to even get an attempt. That was a very high snap.
Yeah.
Chase Deering did a great job going up to get that.
And Rochester lucky, too, because, you know, otherwise you take the ball over at the inside your own 5-yard line.
Right.
So they gained 15 yards on the block.
First and 10 for the Z's at their own 24-yard line, going to our left with 7 seconds to play in the first quarter. I-backs for Hunting. John under center. Takes a snap, back to pass. Here comes a little pressure. Throws down the near side, looking for Heckethorne. Wynn holds it up, and it is incomplete. Off the fingertips of Jay Heckethorne, and it'll be 1.2 seconds to play in the first quarter. The Wynn held it up just a little bit because Heckethorne had about 2 steps on the defender, and that'll bring up second down and 10.
And that's all you're hoping to hold your breath for there is because Hunting really put that ball up high into the air, and the way this wind blowing out of the northwest, it just really caught it.
So second and 10 for the Rochester Zebras at their own 24 with 1 second to play in the first quarter. Hadashell again dots the eye. Heckethorne wide to the near side. Bennett split right. Heckethorne gets to make that. Hadashell gets the carry. There's the clock has expired out for the first quarter. Hadashell down the near sideline. Lowers his head to the 36. Falls ahead to the 38. First and 10 for the Zebras. When we go, come back for the second quarter. After one, no score here at Barnhart Field. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
Shepherd's made my buying process easy. The sales staff at Shepherd's was extremely knowledgeable and helped me find the right vehicle at a price that fit my budget. They had a great selection of new and pre-owned vehicles to choose from, and they gave me a great deal on my trade-in. I wouldn't shop anywhere but Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester. They really are my local hometown dealer.
Are you tired of your internet speed slowing you down? Not a problem. Get connected at the speed of light over RTC's advanced fiber optic network. Work, surf, or play on the net faster than ever before. Choose from multiple residential or business packages with speeds so fast, it'll have you flying away. Already have RTC's Fiber Connect internet? Upgrade your package today. RTC. Local services, local support, and local investments.
Daddy! What channel is the Family Network on?
We don't have that channel, Ma.
What channel is the Science Channel on?
We don't have that channel either, Ma.
How about the Hallmark Movie Channel?
Ma, we don't have any of those channels.
Well, why not?
Because we don't have digital tier.
So we don't have any of the digital tier channels?
Why do you think I'm always playing video games, Ma?
Because you don't have a girlfriend.
Inside the 40 for Rochester. Here's the pitch to Beck. Beck with blockers in front. Beck runs over a tackle and it's a first down. He's still on his feet. Beck at the 20, the 15, the 10, the 5. Touchdown! Back at Rochester High School as we go to the second quarter, scoreless here between the Zebras and the Wabash Apaches. As time expired in the first quarter, Jacob Hadashell took the ball 14 yards and carried it out to his own 39-yard line. So that's where we start here in the second quarter with Rochester now going to our right with the wind and the ball on the far hash.
Some final scores that have come in so far. Culver 28, Triton 0, North Manchester 27, Tippecanoe Valley 20.
First and 10, Wes Beck. Gets the carry, hit immediately in the backfield. And every time Wes Beck has got the football, he has been driven backwards, which is very hard to believe. You know, he's a big kid. And Wabash definitely winning the war up front as Beck's going to lose a yard, and that'll be second and 11. Now back at the 38-yard line of the Rochester Zebras.
At 6'3", 220, it's kind of hard to hide that fullback back there.
Yeah.
But still.
And it's impossible to handle him one with one man, so you know that two or three or four are getting there for Wabash.
And Wabash is doing a good job of doing that.
Second and 11, Hunting under center. Back to pass, looks right. Throws to the near side, complete to Heckathorn. Heckathorn trying to shake a tackler, cannot. Great job on the near side by Wabash's Trevor Gray, who just grabbed him and held on for dear life. Heckathorn gets the ball out across the 45 to the 47-yard line.
Pick up a seven.
And it'll bring up third and three for the Rochester Zebras at their own 47. Ball in the near hash going to our right. Brad Thomas, Travis Watering, I'm David Musselman. Heckathorn split to the left side, wide side of the field. Bennett split right. Make that Kistler tight end to the left. I-backs for Hunting. Here comes a little blitz from Wabash, and the ball just did get handed off to Hadashell as Hunting had an Apache on his back as he handed off to Hadashell. He gets two. It'll bring up fourth and one.
Now both linebackers for Wabash blitzed on that play. Hadashell did a good job getting past the blitz, but he wasn't able to get past the corner that was the outside linebacker coming in making the tackle.
They showed that blitz immediately, too.
Yeah. Make it fourth and two. Give him 1 yard on the carry. Fourth and two for Rochester at their own 47-yard line. Bennett split left. Two tight ends for Rochester. Flanker to the left is Heckathorn. Another blitz coming. Heckathorn goes to the left side, gets the pitch coming left. Heckathorn met in the backfield, shakes the tackler, looking to get upfield. Heckathorn, second effort, gets him to the 49-yard line.
Not going to get it.
And that's going to be, well, the spot on this side is he's not going to get there. Give him one. It'll be turnover on downs. Wabash's ball.
Again, Rochester's offensive line just getting the snot beat out of them by Wabash's defensive front four. And then you throw the blitz every the last three plays there for Wabash, they're bringing one or both linebackers.
Coach Zander said key to victory was battle up front, which Wabash is winning.
Oh, boy.
And Zebras had a muff punt already. And he said turnovers as well. So
penalties killed them that first drive. And the second time they got the football or attempted, they fumbled the ball but held Wabash on downs. So first and 10 for the Apaches at their own 49, at their own 48 going to our left. Chase Dierig in the shotgun formation. Proctor to his left. Three receivers to the right, one to the near side. Here's a snap. Proctor gets it. Hit immediately and dropped in the backfield for a loss of two. And it'll be now second and 12 for the Apaches.
We know it's Saturday, so the boys, it might have been a different feeling out there.
Yeah.
Being not playing on Friday night, but they got to get over that. They're already in the second quarter.
Yeah.
It's another football game. They got to start focusing.
I'm not sure
more.
It was ever all right.
Yeah, it's true.
Ask Coach Zander when he comes up here.
I will ask that, actually.
Yeah, will you? Okay.
Oh, wait, no, you have the microphone. You have to do it.
You're braver than I am, then. Second and 12 for Wabash after a two-yard loss by Proctor from the shotgun. Dierig passes out in the flat to Cole. Cole has it and met by a couple of Zebras, but he did a great job picking up about 8 yards and to bring up third about four for the Apaches.
Tackled by 69, Connor McLaughlin.
Make that third and four for Wabash. Ball back in Rochester territory inside the 45 at the 44 under 9 minutes to play in the first half. On third and four, Chase Dierig from the shotgun, Proctor to his right. Back to pass, looks left. Here comes some pressure, now rolls right. Turns around, he runs into Zebers and gets away from him. Now rolls to the near side, but he can't get rid of all of him. He's sacked back at the 48-yard line. So that gain that he just had, Markoff, a loss of about 8 yards. It'll bring up fourth and 12. And Rochester did a great job pursuing him.
Yeah, Ariel Harper got in there first, but then he got away from Ariel Harper. He went rolled out to his left side, and then Harper actually came back with the sack. So good job by the quarterback and Harper. Well,
that just shows the athleticism of Chase Deere.
Yeah, absolutely.
And Harper's holding his right shoulder. And punt formation now for the Apaches. Eden just gets it away before it's blocked by Beck. Heckathorn this time going to let it bounce. It takes a Rochester bounce and rolls sideways towards the Wabash sideline. It comes to rest at about the 16. We'll take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. 7:57 to play in the first half. Rochester and Wabash still scoreless here at Barnhart Field. And on the first play on this series, Rochester throws a complete that is intended for Brett Abbott down the near sideline. Great defensive play by Wabash. Broke up the play. But to that one, even with the win, it was thrown short because Abbott had two or three steps in the defender.
So far on every play, Rochester's had the open on the receivers. They just can't get the ball that far downfield.
Second and 10. West Beck finally with room to run. Carries it across the 20-yard line to about the 21-yard line, giving five-ish. It'll be third and five for the Zebras.
Even that, with room to run, he looks like he's carrying 18 cinder blocks with him because he's got defenders hanging off of him.
And that's right at the line right at the contact.
Yeah.
Third and five. Make that third and four for the Zebras. At the 22, their own 22, Hunting under center on third down and four. Loses the football. He falls down. The ball is loose. No indication yet. It's Wabash ball, but Rochester recovers and loses fourth a few down. Yards. It'll be fourth down and about five. And on comes the punting unit. The punter is Wes Beck.
Well, I would say after watching the Zebras play last Friday night and then watching them play the first quarter and a half today, they're definitely a mental breakdown here this afternoon.
That's something I was concerned about, not playing to their potential and playing down to their opponent, which I can't really say playing down to their opponent because Wabash is out playing us right now.
Oh, absolutely.
Especially on the line.
I believe Grant Derrick is the one back to receive the punt.
He's real far.
Beck gets the snap. Gets it away off the side of his foot. It wobbles. It takes a Wabash bounce and bounces to the Rochester sideline. But that punt is going to be down at the 44-yard line of the Zebras. So Wabash will take over in this series in very good field position.
About a 20-yard punt with the wind behind you.
Yeah, and then the Wabash back was almost at the 40-yard line of the other side.
Yeah.
So Wabash first and 10 at the Rochester 44. Ball in the near hash going to our left. 6.5 minutes to play in the first half. Still scoreless here at Rochester. Two receivers to the right for Wabash. Two to the near side. Chase Deering in the shotgun formation with Proctor to his left. From the 44 of the Zebras, here's the snap. Proctor gets the carry up the middle. Hit by Schaefer and a wholesale Zebra tacklers, but second effort gets him out to the 42. A carry that probably normally results in zero with great individual effort, gives him two, so it'll be second and eight.
Well, on that play, Proctor's the one that made contact. He's the one that hit the line. The Zebras were just hanging on until he finally just ran out of gas and fell down after a two-yard gain.
6:10 to play in the first half. Second down and eight for the Apaches at the Rochester 42-yard line. Ball in the near hash going to our left. Proctor now to the right of Deering. Chase Deering gets the snap. On the option, goes right. Fakes the pitch, keeps it, goes left, stays right, goes to the 40, gives him two more. It'll be third and six. He thought about pitching at that time and didn't.
He had the pitch ran wide open on the right side, but I think he made the smarter decision there.
Nice job by the Zebra defense, really containing that option play by the Wabash Apaches. It'll bring up third down and six for Wabash at the 40-yard line of the Rochester Zebras. The Apaches with two receivers to the near side, one to the far. Out of the shotgun is Deering. Back to pass. Throws left on the little screen. Wide receiver screen. It's Vest. Vest then brought down inside the Rochester 40 to about the 42. And that'll bring up third down and make that fourth down and about three for the Apaches.
Four down territory, I'm assuming.
I would say, yeah.
Yeah.
As well as your defense is playing?
Absolutely. Exactly.
Fourth and three for the Apaches at the Rochester 37. Wabash has two receivers to the near, one to the far. Grant Deering is the split out to the right side of the field, which is the wide side. Chase Deering in the shotgun formation. Proctor to his right on fourth and three for the Apaches. Here's the snap, back to pass. Looks left, throws left. It is complete. And that was out to Cole. Cole carries it to the 32 and a first down for the Wabash Apaches. Got to be careful. That Cole caught the ball on his knees, and then
drilled.
The Zebras lit him up. And about a second after the play, first and 10 for the Apaches. Deering gives to Proctor. Proctor on the option up the middle. Proctor inside the 25, down to around the 21.
Not for a first down.
Hats off again to the Wabash offensive line. They are just blowing our defensive linemen back. They are giving Proctor and Deering all the time of day back there right now.
Well, right now, this ball game, the execution all lies on the side of Wabash. They're executing on the offensive line. They're executing defensively. Their backs and their receivers are executing perfectly.
Yep. Absolutely.
So it'll be first and 10 for the Apaches at the Rochester 21. Proctor got a fake handoff. And then on the pass, Schaefer rips Deering to the ground. It was a pretty good fake. The only one that wasn't faked out there was Schaefer, and he dropped him for about a 5-yard loss back to the 26.
That was a great individual effort by Jordan Schaefer.
Schaefer got there just the right time because there was a Wabash receiver open on the left side.
Second and 15 now for the Apaches. Ball back at the Rochester 26. 3:40 to play in the first half. No score. Proctor to the left of Chase Deering. Three receivers. Deering back to pass. A little screen. Complete to Proctor. Proctor kicks it out to the right. Proctor back inside at the 10. And actually cut down it before the 10. Maybe give him the 12. Give him
another first down, though.
Yeah. I like the screen call there, especially after.
Well, they're going to call him short of the first down.
Yeah, I think he gave him 14, so it'll be third and one.
After the big sack by Schaefer, you're expecting another pass here, so the Zebra defensive front was in there so quick.
Yeah.
The offensive line just lets him go, and the screen was perfectly executed.
3 minutes to play first half. The Apaches have it third and one on the Rochester 11-yard line.
Eighth play of the drive.
Proctor to the left of Deering is in the shotgun. Deering just follows him right up the middle. Deering has stood up at the line of scrimmage. He's stretching forward. Second effort might have got him the first down. The mark on the near side, I don't know. I don't think the Rochester Zebras gave him anything. It'll be fourth and one. They're going to say no gain. From this vantage point, it looked like second effort might have got him there. But second effort actually got him back to the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, the Zebras front four did a good job that time of stopping Deering.
So it'll be fourth and one for Wabash at the Rochester 11-yard line with 2:15 to play in the first half. Still scoreless here at Barnhart Field. We're down to 10 on the play clock, and it looks like Wabash is going to be content to let that run down to one and take a timeout. And that's exactly what they're going to do. No score here at Rochester with 2:05 to play in the first half. We'll take a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. Back at Rochester High School, under center are the Apaches. He pitches it out to Proctor, does Deering, and Deering goes backwards. First and 10 for the Z's at about the 15-16-yard line of the Rochester Zebras. Now under 2 minutes to play in the first half as the clock rolls on a change of possession.
Wabash, you're getting their opportunities. That's about it.
Yeah, right? You know, Val just said that's not a very good play call. And, you know, why would you go under center when you've been in the shotgun for, well, 2.5 games?
Yeah.
First and 10 for Rochester at their own 16. Now going to our right on the jet sweep. Heckathorn has it. Heckathorn cuts it back inside a block. Gets it out to the 24-yard line. Nice run. As he gets 8 yards, it'll be second down and 2 with 1:45 to play in the first half.
I'm just waiting for Hunting to look over at Bennett again. It's been a while.
It has been a while.
I don't like that. He's thrown the ball 3 times since, and not one of them has been to Bennett's side.
Second down and 3 for the Zebras. 90 seconds to play in the first half. They got all 3 of their timeouts. Hunting under center with IMAX behind him. Hunting fakes a handoff, rolls left. Here comes some pressure. Throws it down the far side, looking for Shane. It is picked off. Like that Kissler.
Looking for Kissler.
Is that Bennett?
So
looking for Kissler. Bennett was over on this side.
Definitely a poor choice by Hunting, based on the results of the play. But you got 3 receivers running deep patterns, and he throws to the only one that's double covered.
And again,
and it's the short defender. I mean, the one that's playing on the. Behind the receiver that made the catch.
Bennett is getting single coverage, too, by the same 5'9 guy.
He didn't look at anybody else.
That's what I'm saying. I don't get it.
He threw to his first option, who was double covered, and he underthrew him. So I don't get it.
Which resulted in an interception. So Wabash has the football at their own 40, make that the Rochester 49-yard line with 1:17 to play in the first half. And now they'll have 4 receivers, 2 to the left, 2 to the right. Chase Deering in the shotgun formation. And pitches out to Proctor. Proctor coming to the near side. Cuts it back inside. Proctor is spun down then at the 44. Giving 5. It'll be 2nd and 5. With 67 seconds to play in the first half. Wabash quickly on the football.
Is that the 3rd turnover already for the Zebras?
I have a muff putt and I have an interception. So
yeah,
okay. I have
2. They have put it on. They have, yeah, tried. 2nd and 5. High snap. Deering back to pass. Rolls right. Throws right. It is complete on the far side. And it's first down. Now at the ball at the 35-yard line of the Rochester Zebras. Wabash pushing. They've got two timeouts with 51 seconds to play in the first half. The Wabash Apaches quickly on the ball. Clock stops as they reset it. Now rolls again with 48. Derrick back to pass. Looks to the near side. Steps up. Steps up again. Now keeps it and runs. Derrick sidesteps one tackler. Pushes his way inside the 30. Down to around the 29-yard line.
How strong is Derrick? Not only can he run away from the pressure, but when he does get hit, he drives the pile towards the goal line. That's usually something you see from a fullback or a tailback.
Give him six. It'll be second and four. Timeout Wabash. We'll take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football 92.1 WROI. Welcome back to Rochester High School. Time ticking away here in the first half. No score yet, but Wabash has it second down and four inside the Rochester 30-yard line. Going to our left, they've got one timeout left.
And they've been knocking on the door all day.
This is the third trip they've had inside on the Zebra side.
Out of the shotgun is Chase Deerig. Proctor to his left on second down and four. Here's the snap. Flips it out to Proctor on the near side. It's a run. It's a lateral. Proctor looking for the sideline. The official is going to not signal anything. Did he get out of bounds? He did not get out of bounds, and he did not pick up the first down. He got 3 yards. It'll bring up third down and one, and Wabash will use its final timeout with 15 seconds to play in the first half. We'll take another 30-second break. You're listening to Zebra Football 92.1 WROI. Welcome back to Rochester High School. Wabash had to use their final timeout because Proctor could not get out of bounds. It looks like he slid but did not slide out of bounds. He slid inbounds, which means as soon as his knee hit before he gets to the sideline, that play keeps running. And the worst part about it is he didn't get a first down, so now they're looking at third and one with 18 seconds to play in the first half, and now they're out of timeouts.
Yeah, but you got to figure they've only got maybe two plays left anyway, and you're inside the Zebra 30-yard line, so I'm going to look for two deep passes to the end zone. Take your shots.
Third and one of the Zebra 26 going to our left. Ball in the near hash. Two receivers on the near side, two to the far. Make that three now to the near side, two to the far, as Deerig is the only one in the backfield. They clear it out, and they'll run an empty backfield here for the Apaches. Deerig is in the shotgun formation. Side is the short side of the field, which is where the three receivers are. Then you've got two receivers to the far. They put 3 seconds back on the clock, so it's 18 seconds to play in the first half. Wabash out of timeouts. Coach McWard discussing something with the head official. So like Brad said, probably two or three plays here, and that's it. Chase Deerig in the shotgun. Proctor goes in motion right. Deerig back to pass. Looks left, steps up, looking for the end zone. Has a receiver. Incomplete. And that was intended for Vest. Good coverage. 101 coverage by Heckathorn. That'll bring up fourth down and one.
I think the wind kind of pushed that one. The receiver had he was open. He had a step and a half across the middle. And the ball was thrown behind him.
Used up 5 seconds on the clock, 13.2 to play in the first half. Fourth and one for the Apaches at the Rochester 26-yard line. And they'll go back to that five-receiver look, three to the left, two to the right. Chase Deerig in the backfield by himself. Proctor goes in motion to the right. Deerig looks to pass, steps up, looks left, steps up. Throws in the back of the end zone. He's got a receiver. It is incomplete.
He dropped it.
Oh, wow. He had it in his hands. Vest had it in his hands and trapped it between his legs, but when doing so, looks like he was out of the back of the end zone, and that'll be first down for Rochester.
Well, I'll tell you what, that was two good athletic plays by, one, the quarterback, Deerig, and two, Vest, the receiver. Unfortunately, Vest, he went up behind the three defenders from Rochester and tried to catch it in the back of the end zone, but when he came down, he lost control of the ball. It fell between his knees, hit the ground, and he curled up around it like you see him do on TV,
but the
official's not fooled.
I couldn't tell from back here.
Yeah, the official's not fooled. Both of them from either side ran into the center of the field waving
off.
Here's
what I saw, though. Chase Deerig put that ball on the money.
Oh, yeah, that's what I said. Yeah. Over the outstretched hands of three Rochester defenders to the back goal line to his receiver.
So Rochester on the ball, first and 10 at their own 26-yard line, going to our right now with 6.8 seconds to play in the first half. Still no score here at Rochester. Hunting under center, takes the snap, hands it off to Hadashell, who fakes a reverse. Now down the left side, Hadashell with blockers in front. Hadashell picking his way through traffic, spins away from one guy, gets it down to the 44-yard line, and finally tackled as he gets to the Wabash 44, and that's where the clock sounds.
30 yards.
The buzzer sounds.
30 yards on the play by Hadashell. He gets caught from behind. from defender on Wabash, but boy, he had blockers in front of him. If he could have got to the left, to the sideline, instead of coming back to the middle of the field, look out.
He really could never go full speed.
No, he never got. He's about 75%, and that's why he got caught from behind.
So we're at halftime. No score here between Rochester and Wabash. Back with the first half recap after this on 92.1 at WROI.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it is brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
Meet Bob and Stan. Both bought new TVs. Stan watches all the popular ringside live events, boxing, wrestling, and the big fight. Bob can't. Stan gets out-of-market sports packages of baseball, hockey, and basketball. Bob can't. Stan gets live concerts and the hottest Hollywood hits. What's the difference? Stan uses InDemand's pay-per-view for all the special events, sports programs, and the newest movie releases. So call RTC today and start your own pay-per-view experience.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
Shepherd's made my buying process easy. The sales staff at Shepherd's was extremely knowledgeable and helped me find the right vehicle at a price that fit my budget. They had a great selection of new and pre-owned vehicles to choose from, and they gave me a great deal on my trade-in. I wouldn't shop anywhere but Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester. They really are my local hometown dealer.
Are you tired of your internet speed slowing you down? Not a problem. Get connected at the speed of light over RTC's advanced fiber optic network. Work, surf, or play on the net faster than ever before. Choose from multiple residential or business packages with speeds so fast, it'll have you flying away. Already have RTC's Fiber Connect internet? Upgrade your package today. RTC. Local services, local support, and local investments.
Daddy! What channel is the Family Network on?
We don't have that channel, Ma.
What channel is the Science Channel on?
We don't have that channel either, Ma.
How about the Hallmark Movie Channel?
Ma, we don't have any of those channels.
Well, why not?
Because we don't have digital tier.
So we don't have any of the digital tier channels?
Why do you think I'm always playing video games, Ma?
Because you don't have a girlfriend.
Inside the 40 for Rochester. Here's a pitch to Beck. Beck with blockers in front. Beck runs over a tackler and it's a first down. He's still on his feet. Beck at the 20, the 15, the 10, the 5. Touchdown!
With our halftime comments, be glad you were not in that Rochester locker room at halftime.
Yeah.
Because I'm guessing that was not a pleasant pep talk.
You know, we got a couple of coaches up here now running the clock, and, you know, we mentioned, I'm guessing, that you know, the chances of getting their backside ripped, and we had a coach say they should be getting there.
Yeah. Wabash feeling pretty good about themselves right now. They've been playing pretty well here this first half.
I'd say 2-0 quarter-wise.
Yeah.
We can do that.
Yeah. Rochester literally lucky that there's still a zero on the scoreboard on the guest side.
Yeah, I would say
side.
That. Yeah. You know, if you could put points on the scoreboard for outplaying someone, Wabash is winning.
Well, I mean that in all honesty of the context of the word. Rochester is lucky that Manchester did not get on the football field. I mean, there's a lot of people still think that catch in the back of the end zone should have been 6 points. And so, you know, and then you had the pass that they tried to put over Bennett's head and
a block
field goal.
It could be 17-0.
It could very easily be 17-0 right now.
So the Wabash Apaches will get the football first to start the third quarter. And like we mentioned there in during the halftime show, Wabash is just blowing up our, especially defensively, they're blowing up our front four or five.
Yep, I'm guessing that the there's not 10 players. That's the first problem, I think, for Rochester. There's, maybe six or seven of the five players that are playing the front five on the offense and the front five on the defense probably were challenged pretty heavily here at halftime by the coaching staff. And then I'm guessing that our running backs and our quarterback were challenged pretty heavily at halftime as well.
We have got to get Gavin Bennett into the game.
Yeah, I agree with that. I agree with that. I think our linebackers defensively need to be more active from tackle to tackle.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I mean, I have a little pride at this point. For
yeah,
crying
I mean,
out loud.
There's a 10-yard space from the offensive tackle to the offensive tackle on the other side that Wabash is owning that real estate right
Absolutely.
Now. And I think, you want to take our two defensive tackles and our two middle linebackers and challenge those four young men to do a better job of owning that real estate.
Yeah, absolutely. They are just blowing up the front four and front five. And I don't understand the Gavin Bennett thing. They had that first play, that first catch was easy. The second one that could have been a touchdown, they didn't call a flag. Ever since then, they haven't even looked at him. 0 for 5 everywhere else, though. 0 for 4, 0 for 5.
Luke Proctor back deep to receive the kick from the Rochester Zebras.
For the Wabash Apaches.
For the Wabash Apaches.
From the Zebras.
Right on. You want to switch? I'll let you have the computer.
No, you're good.
We know what you meant.
You're good.
Wilson Lee to kick for the Rochester Zebras. Now going to our left, Wilson Lee gets the green light. Here we go. End over end kick. Proctor takes it at the 20, 25, tries to pop it out the 30, and dodges the tackler at the 35. Right there, Shane to grab him at the 36.
That's something different you see in kickers. I mean, last week it was Plymouth who was putting them in the end zone every time.
Yeah.
And Wilson Lee put that ball probably at the 30-yard line. It makes a big difference on field position.
Wabash is going to get the ball on their own 35-yard line. Is that the worst position they've had in the field all day?
I bet it's close.
Yeah, that's their worst field position of the day.
And we look to the east, and as you can hear, the wind is coming right into the window here and hitting our microphones.
Right out of the northwest, which is a refreshing breeze.
We're facing the north, aren't we?
Yeah.
Good heavens.
You're trying your best.
The Rochester not the only one on their game today.
Off their game. Out of the shotgun is Deerig from the 36. Back to pass, throws left. It is picked. Oh, incomplete. That bounced off a Rochester defender. And then Wilson Lee and Jay Heckathorn ran into each other, and the ball hits the turf.
I think they both wanted the interception.
Three defenders had their hands on it. It falls incomplete.
So it'll be second and 10 for Wabash at their own 36-yard line. Again, Wabash going to our right. Three receivers to the left, one to the near. Chase Deerig in the shotgun formation. Proctor to his right from the shotgun. Here's a snap, high snap on the option. He keeps, takes it up the middle. Chase Deerig at the 49. Brought down after a 13-yard gain and a first down for the Wabash Apaches.
And Brad, there he is again, the best athlete on the field right now.
I agree with you. Until somebody else
proves us wrong,
can step up and prove us wrong right now, Chase Deering, the most valuable player on this football field.
First and 10 for the Apaches at their own 49-yard line. Ball in the near hash. Three receivers to the left, one to the near. Near side is the short side of the field. Chase Deerig looks to the sideline, has the play. Proctor to his right with 10 on the play clock. Has a snap, back to pass, throws left. It is complete to Grant Deerig. Make that incomplete as it hits the ground. It'll be second and 10. That's the second time that, maybe the third time that Chase Deerig has short hopped his receiver.
Yeah, you know, at least on one other occasion, I thought he was intentionally trying to throw it low. And it just went too low on him.
That one in the end zone?
Yeah, but the last couple two here that we've seen, that I think the wind or the pressure or something else has caused him to throw it low.
Second and 10 from the 49 of the Apaches. Wabash of the football. Proctor gets it up the middle. Proctor spins away from one Zebra. He's at the 45 and carries the Zebra to 44. So give him 6 in the play. Give him almost 7 in the play. It'll be 3rd and 3. At the Rochester 44-yard line. Again, Wabash going to our right with 11 minutes to play in the third quarter.
Proctor doesn't look very big out there on the football field. They've got him listed at 5'11 and 189 pounds. Is that right?
No.
Oh, we got it on the wrong side.
Yeah, I'm off my game.
I was going to say, good Lord, he's nowhere near that big.
5'8", 160.
Yeah, 5'8", 160.
On 3rd and 3, there's a flag in the play before the play even gets going. It's usually false start. Well, nope, that's Wabash applauding, so that's going to be an offside or neutral zone infraction. So that's going to be a first down for Wabash. Thank you for the gift. So they'll march out off inside the 40 to the 39. So first and 10 for Wabash now after an offsides penalty on the Zebras. And Wabash has a fresh set of downs with 10:50 to play. In the third quarter, again, no score here at Rochester High School.
Well, that focus that Coach Zander was probably talking about in the halftime didn't seem to carry over yet.
Three receivers to the left, one to the near. Short side of the field is the right side, the Rochester sideline. Chase Dierig and Proctor looking to the Wabash side. Has the play with 10 on the play clock. Now Proctor on the right side of Dierig with 6, with 5, with 4. There's the snap on the option. Dierig has it. Couple of yards on the quarterback keeper. It'll be 2nd and 8. Second down and 8. Ball now at the 37. Again, 10 minutes to play in the third quarter. Brad Thomas, Travis Watering, I'm David Musselman. Two receivers to the left, two to the right. Right side to the short side of the field. Ball in the near hash. Dierig in the shotgun. Proctor to his left. Down to 7 on the play clock. There's a snap. Back to passes. Dierig looks left. Sidesteps one tackler. Now keeps it. Now runs right. Has a blocker. Cuts it back inside. Loses a football as it hits the ground. Nope, but the official's right there on it. Seeing the ground calls the fumble. That'll bring up 3rd and very manageable now for the Wabash Apaches as Chase Dierig carries it to the Rochester 32. So give him about 5 yards, and it'll be 3rd and 3 for the Apaches, who are quickly on the football.
Adam Basham about had a nice little sack right there.
Yeah, he sidestepped him pretty easily the way it looked. So now Wabash will send 3 receivers to the right, 2 make that 3 to the left, 2 to the right. And Chase Dierig is the only one in the backfield with 10 on the play clock. Wabash plenty of time on 3rd down and 3 from the Rochester 32. Back to passes, Dierig. Looks right. Here comes some pressure. Throws it and he gets hit. We got a flag in the play. The pass is complete. As the pass is taken to the 26, but there is a flag on the play.
We're going to have holding, I believe, against Wabash in the backfield. Just about every one of the coaches on the Rochester sideline running out there to pull the flag out of the official's back pocket, waiting on the call.
So it'll be a hold on the Apaches right there at, well, at where this drive started at the 40, at the 39-yard line. So now it'll bring up 3rd down at about 20, that is. So back it up to the 49-yard line, 3rd and 20 for the Wabash Apaches. Now watch the screen of the quarterback keeper.
All right, he's alone in the backfield once again.
3 receivers to the left, wide side of the field, 2 to the near. Chase Gehrig is in the shotgun formation, stands about 5 yards behind the center. Play clock has whistled to start. We have down to 20 the play clock. Wabash with plenty of time. They've got 5 receivers, they're all spread out. Under 9 minutes to play in the third quarter. Back to passes, Chase Dierig looking for the screen indeed. He throws it to the middle of the field. It is incomplete. I'm not sure who that was going to. Maybe Proctor, I guess. It'll be 4th and 20.
Yeah, the screen was definitely there. You had the 3 guys from the Zebras in the backfield just like that. So you knew the offensive line just let him go.
Yeah. And almost, they almost got to him on the screen. They almost sacked him. In fact, if Chase Dierig wouldn't have gotten rid of the ball when he did, it would have been a sack.
Yeah, and Schaefer for Rochester, really the closest player to even to have a chance at the football.
So Yaden back to punt the ball. The up man in the punt formation is Dierig. Look out. Goes straight to the punter. Gets rid of it. Nice wobbly kick. Inside the 5 is Heckathorn. Heckathorn looking to run away from the defense, and he cannot. Grant Dierig runs him down.
He's still
from behind.
Up. He's still up. Now they're going to blow it dead.
Grant Dierig gets him from behind. There's a flag in the play. Is that going to be offsetting? I got to believe one of them is going to be a horse collar.
Well, that's kind of what I was wondering. The first flag I saw come down was after the Wabash player grabbed him by the back of the neck.
Yeah.
But I don't know what the second flag coming in was for.
So the ball is spotted at the 11. That's where they tackled Jay Heckathorn. One flag is at the 11. The other flag was at about at the 25.
Well, now they're going to throw the 2
all the flags together. So it'll be a block in the back on the Zebras.
Yeah.
What about that horse collar for crying out loud?
Well, you know, when when the tackle was made, the official that was closest to the play didn't blow his whistle.
Yeah.
So Heckathorn kept running. We thought that maybe he somehow kept his knees off the ground, but official came in from the other side and blew it dead.
So the ball inside the 10. Obviously at the 11, it's going to be half the distance to the goal, so actually it's going to be at the 9. Huh. It's going to be at the 9-yard line. So first and 10 for the Zebras at the 9. You remember last week they had the ball twice inside the 20, once at the 15, once at the 1, scored both times. It'd be nice for Rochester to put a drive together here with 8:40 to play in the third quarter, no score. From the 9, Beck gets it, hit in the backfield, and he's going to be stopped for nothing. Oh, second effort actually gets him across the 10 to the 14.
He was hit hard in the backfield.
Well, that Wabash defender that hit him, though, didn't really tackle him. He just grabbed a hold of the football.
Yeah, oh, okay.
And so Beck kind of turned backwards to keep a hold of the football, and I think that at that point, nobody really grabbed a hold of his legs. They were all just trying to rip the ball.
What could have been a loss of 2 turns into a gain of 5.
If you don't wrap up 6'1", 220-pound Wes Beck with 2 hands and maybe even 2 more guys with you, you're not taking him down.
Bennett and Heckathorn split to the right side. Ball in the middle of the field. Hunting gives to Beck again. Wes Beck rushes the football out to the The 18-yard line. It'll be 3rd and 1 for the Zebras. Clock rolls, 7:40 to play in the third quarter. Still no score. Rochester the football. Shane brings the play in from the sideline. They break the huddle. They'll send Heckathorn and Bennett wide to the right side. Shane's your tight end left. Split backs for Hunting. On 3rd and 3, now with 8 on the play clock. Hunting under center with 6. Hunting under center with a 5. Beck again, right side. Beck's got the first down. Beck spins inside the 35, gets outside the 25 to the 29, 1st and 10 for the Z's.
Nice job by Wes Beck. That time he actually had some room to run. Picks up 11 yards for the Zebras and gives them that all-important first down to keep this drive moving.
Are you anybody keeping track of first downs? Val, are you keeping track of first downs? Jeez, there hasn't been many. I know that.
I can make it up. Wes Beck, Val. You said it first.
Val's a genius. Crystal ball works every day. 1st and 10 for Rochester, their own 29. Beck again. Beck at the 31. And he's going to get 2. 2nd and 8.
Yeah,
under
play,
7 to play.
That play took way too long to materialize.
So we're down to 6:46 to play in the third quarter. No score here at Rochester. The Zebras 2nd down and 8 at their own 31-yard line. Ball in the near hash. Bennett, Heckathorn, split right. Shane, tight left. Eye backs for Hunting. Hunting gives to Hadashell. Hadashell looking to get back to the line of scrimmage. Maybe a yard, not a lot there. Wabash has blown everything up.
Yeah, Hadashell trying a little misdirection on that play, and unfortunately all the black jerseys went with the direction of the fake and all the white jerseys went with Hadashell.
3rd down and 7.
Maybe time for Bennett yet?
You would think.
Maybe. Please?
Well, the problem is they're going into the wind. That's going to make kind of a tough throw if
slant.
You try to throw
slant.
Yeah.
He's by himself, single coverage. I like it. I'll pass it.
Back to passes. Hunting rolls right, throws right, looking to the sideline. It is complete. Incomplete. Heckathorn had to come back about 5 yards to get that. I thought he got his arms under it, but he did not. And it'll bring up 4th down and 7.
Well, that was a long pass into a stiff wind. I don't know. I'm kind of with you on that one. They had Bennett one-on-one on a slant pattern and didn't even look at him.
Bennett's on the left side, they look right. Bennett's on the right side, they look left.
4th down for Rochester, and Wes Beck will kick into this wind. Back deep is Grant Deerig, and we're going to have
offsides on Rochester, I think.
Ugh.
Offsides on Rochester?
False
start, maybe?
False start. No?
It is offsides. However,
against Wabash.
Still 4th down, though?
Yeah, but it'll be 4th and manageable. Man, you've got to make a stand here soon, don't you? I mean, you've got to try something.
Yeah. Wabash has done a really good job of, you know, putting long drives together. They haven't scored yet, but they've put multiple drives together. Rochester going to, looks like, bring the offense back on the field.
It's not a first down. It's fourth and one.
Yeah.
Fourth and one for Rochester at their own 39-yard line.
T-back. Pounded in there.
Straight T backfield, two tight ends for Rochester, Hunting on the center. Fourth down at their own 39, Hunting Casey in the south. He's got a first down. He carries it out across the 40, down around the 42. First and 10 for the Z's.
Nice job by John Hunting. He went on the first sound, a quick snap, and he catches Wabash maybe on their heels, and he picks up three.
That might have been the break Zebras needed right there.
Well, that's
about
a big call.
It, and
that's
now
a
we
good
have first call. Down.
5.5 minutes to play in the third quarter, no score. We're going back to the straight T. Backfield, two tight ends for the Zebras. Hunting under center from his own 41. Ball in the near hash. Hunting takes a snap, gives to Hattischel. Hattischel up the middle. Hattischel, the best run of the day. Well, second best run as he carries it out to midfield. Give him nine, it'll be second and one for the Z's. If it ain't broke,
don't fix it.
Don't fix it. Go back to that straight T. 5:10 to play in the third quarter. Rochester and Wabash still scoreless here at Barnhart Field. Rochester approaching Wabash territory. Ball spot at the midfield. They'll go into the straight tee. Left to right, it'll be Hattischel, Beck, and Heckathorn. Two tight ends. Bennett to the left, Shane to the right. Now Hattischel goes in motion to the right side. Here's a snap. Beck hitting the backfield, bounces off a tackler, still on his feet. Falls inside to 45, down to around the 43. First down for the Zebras.
Nice job by Wes Beck. That was definitely all him on that run. He was hit a yard or two deep in the backfield and just kind of popped backwards and went off to his right side and found a lane. Had he been able to keep his feet and keep his power underneath of him, I think he probably could have taken it.
First and 10 for the Z's at the Wabash 44-yard line. Bennett split to the left. Heckathorn wide to the right. Split backs for Hunting. Hunting gives to Beck going right. Beck, a big hole off the right side. Rochester finally opening some holes as he carries inside the 40 to the 39.
Well, what turned into a quick, almost punt is turning into, well, maybe one of the best drives of the day for the Zebras.
5-yard gain for Wes Beck, and the Zebras looking at third and make that second and five inside the Wabash 40. 4:10 to play in the third quarter, still scoreless here at Rochester. Manchester defeated Tippecanoe Valley earlier, 27-20. They, too, open the conference today. Bennett goes split to the right side. Flanker to the right is Heckathorn. On second and five, Heckathorn gets the pitch coming to the near side. Heckathorn, a great kick out block by Kistler. Heckathorn lowers his head and maybe gets back to the line of scrimmage. He ran a long way for a no gain. Wabash is getting so much push into the backfield. I mean, Kistler's given a kick out block. I'm talking 5 yards deep in the backfield.
Yeah, and, you know, Rochester's not able to really sustain any of their blocking. Wabash is being relentless on their pursuit for the football. And Rochester, you know, they're getting the initial hit and then nothing after that.
Third and five, an official timeout. Rochester will have two wideouts, Heckathorn and Bennett wide to the right side. Shane will be your tight end to the left. Ball in the near hash, which is Rochester sideline, the short side of the field. Split backs for Hunting. John hands off to Beck. Beck, a huge hole off the right side. Carries the ball inside the 35, give him the 34, and that's going to be close to another Zebra first down.
Another nice run by Wes Beck. That's 12 carries now by Wes Beck. I think that's more than he's had in any of the previous two ball games.
This is by far the only drive today that we've ran 4 or 5 yards, 6 yards at a time.
You're right.
And picked up how many first downs so far?
Yeah.
We probably doubled our output already today.
Yeah.
Now to the shotgun goes Hunting. Hattischel to his right, Beck to his left, two wideouts, one to each side. On the draw, Hattischel gets it going left, cuts it back into the middle. Still on his feet, second effort, carries it inside the 30, and he gets close to the 27-yard line. He's going to pick up about seven, and it's going to be second down for the Z's, second and short three. And you know what? Yeah, give him the 27. 2.5 to play in the third quarter. Rochester and Wabash scoreless here at Barnhart Field. Zebras quickly on the ball on the near hash. Bennett comes wide to the near side, short side of the field. Abbott now the split out wide to the right. Shane is split, make that tight to the right. Hunting under center with split backs behind him on second and three. Had a shell, stacked up at the line of scrimmage. And second effort might have got him a yard, maybe. It'll bring up third and about two for the Z's as we come down inside 2 minutes to play in the third quarter.
I'll tell you what, we got 2 minutes to go in the third quarter and we got the entire fourth quarter. And if Rochester does not score on this drive, they may only have one more opportunity.
Yeah, you're right. As quick as this game's going.
Wabash has done a fantastic job of running, you know, their offense and sustaining long drives. And yeah, Rochester may only get one other opportunity.
Straight T backfield on third down and two. Two tight ends, Bennett to the left, Kistler to the right, and Hadashell's met and hit in the backfield and driven backwards. And that's going to bring fourth down and four after a three-yard loss.
The defensive tackle, Elijah Robinson for Wabash, was in the backfield before Hadashell almost had the ball.
Fourth and four for the Zebras, and they will go for it. Ball at the 29-yard line. With 1:10 to play in the third quarter.
Can I ask again?
No.
This is the
not Bennett time?
This is the second fourth down play for
on
Rochester
the series, yep.
This series.
Bennett split to the right side. Had a shell wide to the near side. Back to pass is Hunting. Hunting looking for Bennett. Bennett runs into a defender. No flag. Turnover on downs.
They've looked at Bennett three times now. One time was complete. The next two, I think two flags could have been thrown easily.
Two so it'll be first down for the Apaches as they dodge a bull as Rochester put together their best drive of the day and, again, come up empty.
Rochester defense is going to have to get a stop. They're going to have to force Wabash into a three and out or a turnover of some sort. You can't allow them to have 6-7 minutes worth of offensive field.
Especially if it ends with a score.
58 seconds to play in the third quarter. No score. Wabash has it first and 10 at their own 29 going to our right. And then we're going to have a flag on the play again.
I think it was false start.
It'll be false start against the Wabash Apaches. And that'll back them up five. So now first and 15. Again, no score here at Rochester. Time ticking away here in the third quarter. And now it'll be first and 15 for the Apaches at their own 24-yard line. Ball in the near hash. They've got four receivers, two to the left, two to the right. Derrick is in the shotgun with Proctor to his left. Sets a club with 15 on the play clock. Now's a snap. Proctor takes the carry. Proctor going right, cuts back to the middle. Proctor still on his feet to the 30 and is finally brought down at about the 33-yard line. He got the 5 yards back plus three. It'll be second and seven, a short seven, a long six. 35 seconds to play in the third quarter. Wabash, second down and six at their own 33. Proctor to the right of Deering, who's in the shotgun formation. Proctor again, takes the carry left side, gets to the 36 and driven backwards. So he's gonna gain three more, and that's probably gonna take care of the third quarter. No score here at Rochester High School. When we come back, Wabash will be looking at third down and about three from Rochester High School on 92.1 WROI.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it is brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
Meet Bob and Stan. Both bought new TVs. Stan watches all the popular ringside live events, boxing, wrestling, and the big fight. Bob can't. Stan gets out-of-market sports packages of baseball, hockey, and basketball. Bob can't. Stan gets live concerts and the hottest Hollywood hits. What's the difference? Stan uses InDemand's pay-per-view for all the special events, sports programs, and the newest movie releases. So call RTC today and start your own pay-per-view experience.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
Shepherd's made my buying process easy. The sales staff at Shepherd's was extremely knowledgeable and helped me find the right vehicle at a price that fit my budget. They had a great selection of new and pre-owned vehicles to choose from, and they gave me a great deal on my trade-in. I wouldn't shop anywhere but Shepherd's Chevrolet Buick in Rochester. They really are my local hometown dealer.
Inside the 40 for Rochester. Here's a pitch to Beck. Beck with blockers in front. Beck runs over a tackler and it's a first down. He's still on his feet. Beck at the 20, the 15, the 10, the 5. Touchdown! Rochester High School going to the fourth quarter. Congratulations to the Rochester Ladies Zebra cross country team today. Won the Manchester invite. I was there this morning.
Oh, yeah.
I've never been to a cross country meet.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah. Maya runs sixth grade cross country, and she ran this morning at 9. And, you know, I'm pretty proud of her. She did a great job this morning, knocked off a minute.
Yeah.
And it makes you want to go home and run, right?
It does not.
It does not.
Nothing.
Something tells me about you and your personality that you're the one dad standing on the sideline yelling, pick those feet up!
You know the reason why she runs cross country?
Because you know zero.
Because I know nothing about it. Third and a short three for Wabash. Proctor, make that chase. Derrick looks to run, now throws it up for grabs. He had a receiver crossing the middle of the field and overthrows him, and that'll bring up fourth down for the Wabash Apaches at their own 36-yard line.
Well, Proctor is 7 of 16. I'm sorry, Deering, 7 of 16 on the game, but he's missed his last six attempts throwing the football.
And it looks like they will line up to punt. I'm going to say line up to punt because the up man is the quarterback.
Right, and they always put a man in motion just that comes across just before the ball snaps. So, you know, you got a couple options there for a fake almost every time they get set up to punt.
Yeadon back deep. Dylan goes in motion to the far side. There's a
fake
quarterback. Fake to the quarterback. And Chase Derrick looking for the first down. He's got it. And he carries a whole slew of Zebra tacklers inside the 45 down to around the 47.
The first down mark was at the 39-yard line, and he got hit the 36, 35, and he carried the Zebras with him.
Here's what I saw on every play except for that one, their punt. Derrick leaves his hands on his knees the entire time. That time, his hands were at his waist, ready to receive the snap.
He looked like he was in a shotgun position. He had his hands up and ready.
I think everyone in this whole house knew there was going to be a fake there.
But that's, again, the athleticism of Derrick to battle for 9 yards and a first down when his team needed it.
First and 10 for Wabash at their own 47 after the fake punt. And here's the play. Derrick keeps it on the option. Up the middle, inside the 45, giving the 45. And I thought maybe that time Vest turned the corner and headed upfield before the ball was snapped, but no call.
Yeah. I think a couple of the people on the sideline, on the Rochester sideline, thought the same thing from the reactions I was seeing.
8-yard pickup for Chase Derrick. The ball's now at the Rochester 45-yard line. 11 minutes to play in the game, no score.
A lot of excitement on the Wabash sidelines.
Should be. Absolutely. Three receivers to the right, one to the left for Wabash. Proctor to the left of Derrick's in the shotgun. From the 45 on second and two, Proctor gets it going right, and he is spun down right at the line of scrimmage. It'll be third and two. 10:45 to play in the football game. Again, the first game of the TRC. Next week, back on the road, going to Northfield. Maybe the last time we play Northfield in a while.
It could very well be.
Third down and two for the Apaches. Derrick in the shotgun. On the option, he'll take it up the middle. He's got a first down. He loses the football, and then picked up by Abbott. Abbott is on the run. Abbott dodges one tackler. He's to the near sideline. Carries the ball into Wabash territory. First and 10 for the Zebras.
Nice job by Brett Abbott. Deering. Oh, we got a late flag coming in on the scrimmage there.
That might have been some words said or some.
Something.
Unsportsmanlike
conduct.
They're
definitely an unsportsmanlike penalty. It's just a matter of who's going to get a call.
I've got to tell you, fellas, that throw by the official for the flag, that thing was up there about 15 feet.
Yeah, he threw that high.
That was a fantastic job by Abbott. The personal foul
the Zebras.
Against the Zebras.
It might have been against Abbott as well, though.
Abbott was right as the safety on defense. He was in the right spot at the right time. The ball was stripped away from Chase Derrick. It took one bounced right into the hands of Abbott, who was already in full stride.
He gained about 12 yards on the pickup off the fumble, maybe 15. But then we're going to take it right back to about the spot of the fumble.
Sounds sportsmanlike. How many yards is that?
15.
15, yeah.
So Rochester will take over on down. Well, will take over after the turnover.
So throw some cold water on all the excitement that the Zebras got off that fumble return.
Well,
but let's hope that they can
build
put something
that.
Together. 10 minutes left.
41-yard line is where this series will start. Heckathorn wide to the near side. Bennett split left. Ball in the far hash. Eyebacks for Hunting. From their own 41, Hunting back to pass. Gets away from a defender. It's a design quarterback run. Hunting sidesteps one tackle. Still on his feet. Hunting at the 40, the 35, the 30, the 20, the 25. We're going to the end. Caught from behind. John Hunting has come from behind inside the 10. But they're, what?
We had two Rochester.
A lot going on.
Heckathorn and a Wabash player just about come to blows at midfield. None of the officials saw it, but the Rochester coaches saw it, and they were all over Heckathorn telling him to run away from the Wabash
defender. Were you watching
that?
Yeah.
And I was waiting for a flag to come flying because if Hunting had scored, it was all coming back.
Hunting is 30 yards down the field, and Heckathorn's in the back just throwing that Wabash kid off of him.
And the Rochester coach is yelling at Heckathorn, run away from him, run out of bounds, do something, just get the heck away from him.
Well, they're Wabash Apache down on the field, down on the ground. Christina Hughes out there, he is helped up. He will walk off the field. But in the meantime, John Hunting on what looked like a busted play, but I think it was really designed quarterback keeper, should have been tackled for about a 3 or 4 yard loss. Instead, carries the ball inside the 10 down to the 8 yard lines, where it's first and goal for the Zebras at the Wabash 8.
52 yard run by Hunting on, yeah, what looked like for the first 10 yards of that play was a busted play, and he was just scrambling for anything that he could get. And somehow the defense just kind of fell away and opened up, and he was able to get 52 yards for the Rochester Zebras.
Must begin to say, down at the whatever yard, and then we look up again, and there's Hunting
four yards
in front of everybody.
Grant Deering basically made one last ditch effort to tackle him. He laid out for him and just caught a shoestring and brought him down inside the 10 at the 8.
Thank good Musselman was watching the ball, because Travis and I was watching the
almost
a fight at midfield.
You both were beating on me, and I had no idea what was going on.
And I wouldn't want to fight Heckathorn.
No.
Straight T backfield. Rochester, everybody in tight. Kissler tight to the right. Bennett tight left. Had a shell. Beck, Heckathorn left to right in the backfield. First and goal from the 8 for the Z's. Hunting under center. John takes the snap, and there ball's loose. Wabash is going to pick it up at the 5.
Good
Hunting Lord. Was trying to hand it off to Heckathorn. Heckathorn had no idea it was coming to him. And then Haddishell was kind of looking at Hunting with his palms in the sky, thinking, what is that?
Wabash football on the 5-yard line of the Rochester Zebras.
So was it on the snap or on the handoff?
It was on the handoff.
On the handoff, okay.
And there was
Hunting had no idea he was getting the football. And
Heckathorn
had no idea he was supposed to get the football. He wasn't looking for it. He didn't have his hands in the right position. And Hunting was trying to force it in there, and he let go, and the ball just kind of hung there in midair.
First and 10 for the Apaches at their own 4-yard line after a fumble. Gives it right back to Wabash.
Wow.
Ball in the near hash. Wabash going to our left into the wind. Two receivers on the near side, short side of the field, two to the far. Out of the shotgun is Derek in the end zone, gives to Proctor. Proctor stood up right at the line of scrimmage, maybe to give him the 5. It'll gain 1, it'll be 2nd and 9. McLaughlin and Schaefer on the tackle for the Zebras with 9:15 to play in the game, no score. 2nd down and 9 for the Apaches at their own 5. They'll send three receivers to the wide side of the field, one to the near side. Shotgun is Deerig with Proctor to his left, stands on the goal line now. Deerig takes a snap on the quarterback option. He's going to lose yards, and he fumbled it. Rochester says they have it.
They do.
Rochester has it at the 6.
Jeez.
He got lit up at the 5-yard line and coughed it up again, and the Zebras take over on the fumble recover by Schaefer.
Adriel Harper was the first one to make contact, and I'm going to assume that he was the one that caused the fumble.
Does somebody want to make up their mind? Does somebody want to win this game? Or?
Rochester first and goal now from the Wabash 6 with 8:55 to play in the game. Still no score here at Barnhart Field. They're going to come back with the same look they had a minute ago. Shane is your tight end to the right. Uh-oh. Bennett tight left. Straight T backfield. Bennett under center. Make that Hunting under center. Hunting takes a snap. Gives to Hattischel. Hattischel spins away from one tackler. Gets down to the one. Giving file to be second and goal from the one. Clock rolls with 8:40 to play in the game. Rochester has second and goal from the 1 yard line. Ball in the near hash. Brad Thomas, Travis Watring, I'm David Musselman. They come to that same.
Defensively, Wabash has no idea what they're doing. This is the second play in a row they've had to run a player off at the last second.
From the one, Hunting takes the snap. Hattischel going right, looking for the end zone. Second effort, stands him up with no gain. It'll be third and goal from the one.
Still can't get in.
Duh.
Here's what I would do. Are you ready for it?
Westbeck?
No.
I'd do a keeper. Fake the Hattischel going right, and Hunting just keep it and keep
rolling.
I'm
not even sure I would fake. Just take
just
it.
Just go.
Naked bootleg off to the left side.
Follow Basham right up the middle.
Yep.
Third and goal from the one for the Zebras. Shane, tight right. Bennett, tight left. Straight T backfield for Rochester. Everybody in tight. Third and goal. Hattischel this time left side looking for the end zone. Touchdown, Zebras!
Nice job by Hattischel coming from the opposite direction, and he gets it across the goal line for the score for the Zebras.
I was wrong.
I was wrong, too. But, hey, they scored.
7:48 to play in the football game. And the first 6 points hit the scoreboard. And that come from Jacob Hattischel.
Huge sigh of relief from every person on this side of the football.
Wilson Lee on to attempt the kick. Snap is down. Snap is back. Hold is down. Kick is away. And it is good. 7-0 Rochester. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. 7:48 to play in the football game. Finally, we see some points.
Three plays, 6 yards, 1:07 taken off the clock, capped off by a Jacob Hattischel 1 yard touchdown run. The PAT by Wilson Lee was good. Zebras lead 7-0 with 8 minutes to go in the game.
And that was all set up after a 52-yard run by Hunting. Puts them inside the five.
Yep.
They fumble it on the ensuing play. And then the defense comes out and forces the turnover to give the ball back to Rochester on the 6 yard line, and they're able to finally punch it across.
So Rochester will kick off. Proctor stands deep inside the 20. Wilson Lee to do the kicking for the Rochester Zebras, kicking with the wind.
Central Michigan leads Purdue 31-10.
Central Michigan leading Purdue 31-10. Wilson Lee, a nice kick.
Away
at the
from
10,
the...
stay in bounds. And goes out of bounds.
Absolutely.
Nuts.
Wow.
And Proctor's pumping his fist because that ball went out of bounds. If it didn't, they're in a bit of trouble.
Yeah, I mean, it went out of bounds at the 4 yard line. So that was, you know, a great effort by the kicker for Rochester, but Abbott.
So Wabash will get it after the kick goes out of bounds at the 35-yard line. The young man that was hurt here in the middle of the field in that 52-yard run by Hunting is being attended to on the far sideline by Christina Hughes. Looks like he's holding his right wrist. So the kicking lesson I learned today.
Don't kick it out of bounds?
Well, no.
Okay.
Do you want a lot less rotation when you're kicking it a long way than you do when you're kicking it short?
Okay.
More rotation means you get too much of the bottom of the ball. Less rotation means you get it more flush and more towards the middle of the ball. Okay. Make sense?
Yeah.
They're going to pass, complete to the far side. And Cole carries it out for about a 9 yard gain. So it'll be second down and one for the Apaches. Now Rochester leading 7-0 with 7.5 minutes to play in the football game.
That tip was from Kevin Reaney.
It was.
And Brad, you're going to go home and try, right?
Sure.
Perfect.
You know, Kevin was a really good kicker.
I'm going to see if I can kick it over the roof of the house.
Back in the 1930s at Kokomo.
1930s.
Steering back to pass. And it's picked off.
Jordan Schaefer has his hand on the football. Just can't quite bring it in. He had six.
Oh.
He did.
Yes, he did.
That would have been a pick six for Jordan Schaefer. He could have got his right, or left hand up there to secure it, but he got his big right-handed mitt out there and knocked it down. It'll bring up third and one.
Boy, he looked like a tight end on that one, didn't he?
Yeah. 7:18 to play in the game. Third down and one for Wabash at their own 44-yard line. Chase Deering, the quarterback, Proctor to his right, out of the shotgun, on the fake. Deering down the right side, cuts it back inside, still on his feet, still gaining yards, carries it into Rochester territory, gets it to the 46, first and 10 for Wabash.
Deering going to pick up another 12 yards and a first down.
Where's he at?
He's got 65 yards on 14 carries. He leads Wabash. He's got another 55 yards in the air.
First and 10 for the Apaches at the Rochester 46-yard line. 7 minutes to play in the game. Make it the 45. Ball in the far hash. Four receivers, three to the left, one to the right. Deering in the shotgun with Proctor to his left. On the option, Deering keeps it, stacked up at the line of scrimmage and driven backwards. That hasn't happened very often today.
No, it has. He's only had two other plays all day where he's lost yardage.
Second and 10 for Wabash. Clock continues to roll with 6:40 to play in the game. Again, Rochester up 7-0. Three receivers to the near side, which is the wide side of the field, one split right. Proctor to the right of Deering again in the shotgun formation on second down and 10. There's a snap. Back to pass is Deering. Here comes some pressure. Throws it to the near side. It is incomplete. Oh. Great defensive effort by Jay Heckathorn, who broke up that pass.
He jumped the receiver and tried to catch that one. And again, had he been able to get both hands on it, I don't think he'd have had six on that, but he definitely would have had a couple of steps on that receiver.
Third and 10 for the Apaches of the Rochester 45-yard line. 6:20 to play in the game. Zebras up 7-0.
That's the 19th pass by Deering.
19th pass for 55 yards?
Yeah.
Empties the backfield. Three receivers left, two to the right. Deering, the only one in the backfield.
8 of 19 is what he is.
Chase Deering on third and 10. Back to pass. Looking left. Now in the middle. Now directs traffic. Now throws it down the right side into double coverage. Picked off by Abbott. Abbott intercepts the football. He's got blockers in front. Abbott still on his feet, and he's going to be tackled at the 35-yard line. The Zebras dodge another bullet. They'll take over after the pick at the 35.
Jordan Schaefer doing a great job fighting through a double team and a possible holding to get to Deering just as he tries to step forward and let go of that ball. That in turn leads to the pass being thrown short, yep, and Abbott getting the interception.
First.
Before that, though, Deering did have about 10 seconds of time back there. I'm surprised.
You can direct traffic and wave guys off. You've got plenty of time.
Absolutely.
But like you said, Schaefer was getting double teamed and still made a good effort.
First and 10 for the Z's at their own 34-yard line, coming to our right now. Abbott wide to the near side. Bennett split left. Hunting under center with 6 minutes to play in the game, up 7-0. Beck up the middle of the field, and Beck is cut down shy of the 38, giving the 37. He's got three. It'll be second down and 7 with 5:50 to play in the football game. Again, Rochester up 7-0.
I'm going to guess run.
Absolutely.
Run.
Take that play clock down as far as you can.
Yep.
Ball on the far hash. Bennett tight left. Kistler tight right. The wideout is Abbott. Wide to the near side. Eyebacks for Hunting. On second and 7. Hunting gives to Hadashell going left. Hadashell, stiff arm. Here's a flag in the play. He's got a first down driven out of bounds after a 9-yard pickup. But there's a flag in the play. 5:21 to play in the football game. Wabash says it's against Rochester. It is against Rochester on the hold, so that's going to back him up.
Well, Hadashell, a pretty good effort to pick up the first down. Gives a stiff arm and drives the Wabash player about 3 yards backwards.
Yeah,
it's all going to be for naught as it's going to come back because of the holding.
So that was thrown at the 42, so it's going to back him up to the 32.
Sixth penalty of the day for the Zebras, cost them 55 yards so far.
So now it'll be second and about 13 after the penalty. And the Z's will break the huddle. They'll send Bennett wide to the left side, which is the short side of the field. Abbott split right. Shane is the tight end to the right. And Eyebacks for Hunting on second and 13. John Hunting with 17 on the play clock gives to Hadashell. Hadashell, middle of the field, stood up hard at the 35, falls forward to about the 37, maybe the 36. Looks like he gets about 5 on the pickup. It'll bring up third down at about 8. 5 minutes to play in the football game. 7-0 Rochester here late in this one.
And right now, all Rochester really needs to do is just keep that clock turning.
Absolutely.
You know, if they can pick up a first down, what did you say, 3rd and 8? So, yeah, if they can get the first down, just keep that clock running. That's their best friend right now.
3rd and 8 for the Z's at their own 36. Heckathorn wide to the near side. Bennett split left, split backs for Rochester. Kistler tight right. Hunting back to pass. Looks in the middle of the field, looking for the tight end. It's complete, incomplete to Kistler. Kistler had it in his hands, and great individual effort by the defensive back to knock that away. And now we have a flag in the play late. As that play come to an end, it was late. And boy, you think that the way the Zebras are standing around, it's going to be against them.
Yeah, well, the flag is in the Zebra backfield, so that's a good indication there, too. We got
unsportsmanlike on the Rochester Zebras.
Oh, that's two today.
So back that's going to bring up, well,
15 yards.
Yeah.
And you lose a down, so that makes it fourth down.
Fourth down.
Fourth and about 23.
Yeah. Punter away.
4.5 minutes to play in the game. Rochester looking at now fourth down at about 23 after the penalties walked off against them. They're leading 7-0. But now, instead of punting from about the 20-yard line, they're going to punt from inside the 10. You would hate to give up a block here.
Well, what do we have? We have one punt that went all of about 20 yards. So
maybe
the Wabash receiver, he's back at his own 35.
He's a little too far back, if you ask me.
Yeah, he could probably get away with standing about midfield.
I think so, too.
So Rochester will have to punt the ball away on 4th and 23. Wes Beck will stand at about his own 9 to do that. And Grant Derrick, it looks like, will stand inside his 40 to about the 39. Snap is back, no pressure, off the toe. Fortunately, takes the Rochester hop, but Grant Derrick's going to pick it up at the 47 and driven back hard by Kistler. But Wabash will start in very good field position with 4:21 to play in the football game, with Rochester leading 7-0. They'll start at their own 47-yard line, going to our left.
Well, it falls on the shoulders of the Rochester defense. Wabash has done a fantastic job of controlling the football offensively, putting together some pretty decent drives today. They've taken two or three shots at the end zone today as well. Just haven't been able to come up with that magical touch yet to get it across the goal line.
And I'm calling it a busted play. The busted play is the difference of this game right now.
From Hunting?
Hunting, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
Five receivers for Wabash. Proctor in motion. Gets the carry going right on a jet sweep. Cuts it back across the inside to the in the middle back to the 50-yard line. Give him 3, it'll be 2nd and 7. We're under 4 minutes to play in the football game with Rochester leading 7-0.
Jordan Schaefer again with a good effort, chasing the play from behind, and when Proctor returned to try and come back the other direction, Schaefer was there to swallow him up.
Three receivers to the right, one to the near. Proctor to the left of Derrick, who's in the shotgun formation with 10 on the play clock. Here's a snap. Here comes some pressure on the option. Both hit. Both Proctor and Derrick is driven backwards by, let's see, 6 Zebras. And he's going to lose 3 and another 2, so it's going to be 3rd down and 12. Ball back at the 45. Rochester called a blitz there, and it worked. And that option never got going as both Proctor and Derrick was hit at the same time by a slew of Zebras and driven backwards. 3:15 to play in the football game. 3rd down and 12 for Wabash. Now back at their own 45. Proctor to the right of Derrick with 3 receivers to the left, 1 to the right. From the shotgun, here's the snap. Back to passes. Derrick looks left, looking for the screen. And here comes some pressure. He just throws it down the field. Incomplete. 4th and 12. As Derrick had a lot of pressure by Wes Beck. 4th down and 12 with 3:02 to play in the game. Again, Zebras up 7-0.
Nice job this time by the Rochester defense.
4th and 12 from the Wabash 45-yard line. Again, 3:02 to play in the game. Wabash will have 2 receivers on the near side, 2 to the far side. They're going to our left, ball in the middle of the field. Derrick in the shotgun with Proctor to his left. 4th and 12 for the Apaches. Proctor back to make that Derrick back to pass. Throws to the near side. It is incomplete. Oh. Off the fingertips of Hunting. Just about caught by the receiver on the deflection. And Rochester will take over on downs.
Rochester defenders almost looked like they were trying to do the tip drill, but
amongst themselves, and that didn't work.
Yeah, but the receiver for Wabash was right in between the two of them, and he about had a chance at it as well, but the ball hit the ground, and the Zebras will take over. A little over, just under 3 minutes to go in the ball game. They lead by seven. Hopefully.
And they take over at the Wabash 45-yard line.
Yep.
Bennett split to the right. Ball in the middle of the field. Abbott split left. Split backs for Hunting. On first and 10 for Rochester from the Wabash 45. Here's the snap. Beck going left. Beck sidesteps a tackler. Gets it down to the 42. Hunting is drilled after the handoff. Picks up a couple of yards, but more importantly, clock rolls. 2:45 to play in the game. Give him three. It'll be second and seven.
I think the last thing Coach Zahner wants to do right now is throw the football.
I would. I don't think that's going to happen. Second and seven for the Zebras. 2.5 to play in the game. Taking their time getting on the ball. 10 on the play clock. They just get to the football. Bennett wide to the nearest left side. Abbott split right. Split backs for Hunting with 3 on the play clock. Here's the snap. Hunting will keep it. Cuts it back inside. Hunting at the 40. Pushed ahead to the 39. And Wabash will use a timeout. It'll be third and about 5 for the Zebras when we come back with 2:10 to play in the football game, leading 7-0. You're listening to Rochester Football, 92.1 WROI. 2 minutes, 10 seconds to play in regulation. Rochester leading 7-0. And after the Wabash timeout, Brad, they'll be looking at third down and 5 from the Apache 39.
Yeah, I still say you run it. I cannot, for any reason, see why you'd want to put it up in the air. That you want to keep that clock moving.
Yep.
And I would put them in that wing tee and see if you can't get Hadeshell or Beck.
Well, you know as well as I do, whatever they do here, if they run the football, and even if they gain a couple of yards, it's going to take another 40 seconds off the clock. So that'll take us well inside.
I think it's 2-down territory. You run, you go for it on fourth down.
If they don't get hardly anything here, I think they punt for field position. Just my opinion.
Well, yeah, that's not a bad idea either.
Third and 5. Ball inside the 40 for Rochester. Here's the pitch to Beck. Beck with blockers in front. Beck runs over a tackler and it's a first down. He's still on his feet. Beck at the 20, the 15, the 10, the 5. Touchdown, Zebras. No, he did not get in.
Oh,
got in.
Wave him off. Mark his knee down at
the
1-inch line. And Beck is not happy.
Well, he can't have his knee down at the 1-inch line. I mean, he's 6'3". He's got to lean forward across the goal line for crying out loud.
Oh, good Lord.
And that's what Coach Zahner is saying. This is crazy. How can he be down at the 1-foot line and he leans forward? There is no way that's possible.
What I just learned there, though, seeing Wes Beck run on a 28-27 sweep, full of steam, get out of his way.
If he runs the ball like that all the time, nobody brings him down.
He was not coming down.
And then he ran over a safety that's slow to come off the field.
Oh, my. And blockers in front. Get out of his way.
First and goal from the 1 foot line for the Zebras. They'll bring everybody in tight.
Give it right back to him.
Absolutely. Give it to 22. Hunting under center.
There to go.
Hadeshell will go in motion to the right side. Hunting takes the snap, gives to Beck. Beck, right side of the line of scrimmage, into the end zone. Touchdown, Zebras.
Nice job by Wes Beck. Not on the 1 yard touchdown run, but on the one before that. That should have been the touchdown where he ran over people. He ran through people, and he ran away from people to get the ball down to the 1-inch line.
No way. I'll let it go.
I agree. The man's 6'3", and he's got his entire body in the end zone. How is that down?
Wilson Lee kicks it away. The extra point is good. Rochester leading 14-0. 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. A minute 48 to play in the game. Rochester strikes again here in the fourth quarter.
4 plays, 45 yards, a minute 09 taken off the clock, capped off by a 1 yard Wes Beck touchdown run before his 39 yard run. The PAT by Wilson Lee was good. Zebras lead 14-0 with just under 2 minutes to go in the quarter, in the game.
Well, not too bad an effort when you show up for a 5 minutes of an entire football game and you win by 2 touchdowns.
Good call. Wilson Lee to kick. Rochester up now 14-0. Lee, end over end kick. Proctor takes it at the 16. At the 25, the 30. Proctor still on his feet and he's spun down hard at about the 27. So that's where Wabash will take over. Give him the 31, I'm sorry, the 31-yard line. With a minute 43 to play in the game, Rochester now up 14-0. Post-game show ought to be interesting.
Yeah. I'm going to say disappointed in the line, but he's still happy because they won.
I'm thinking that maybe John ought to have his finger on the sensor button.
Oh, yeah. Crystal ball Val. He said Westbeck big game, and Westbeck big game.
Four receivers now make that five receivers for Wabash. Four to the right, one to the near side. Derek, that is, in the shotgun, stands at his 25-yard line. Chase Derrick takes a snap, back to pass, steps up, looks over the middle of the field, is complete to Dylan. Dylan has a first down as he gets out to about a 13-yard gain. He carries the ball to the 43-yard line. It'll be first and 10 for the Apaches with a minute 38 to play in the game. Brad Thomas, Travis Watring, I'm David Musselman. First and 10 for the Apaches at their own 43. 90 seconds to play in the game. Rochester up 14-0. Five receivers for the Apaches. Derek back to pass again. Looks left. He's going to be hit in the backfield and dropped by the Zebras. First one to hit him was...
I don't know that. 69 is not on the roster.
First one to hit him was Connor McLaughlin, and then 54 brought him down, and he's not on the roster.
Wabash will use a timeout. We'll take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. 1:15 to play in the game. Rochester leading 14-0. Wabash has used, I believe, their second of their three timeouts, and will have a second and 14 back at their 39-yard line, as the first man to hit him there was
Connor McLaughlin.
Was not able to wrap him up, and you know, give Derrick a lot of credit. He kept his feet moving, and he intended to stay on his feet, and that's what he did.
Right.
Then it took two or three other Zebras to come in and finish it off.
Yeah, we've seen Derrick do that a lot today. As you know, he fights off that initial contact, and he's able to maintain his feet and make something out of a lot of busted plays.
Second down and 14 for the Apaches. Four receivers to the right for Wabash. One to the near side, the left. Shotgun formation for Derrick.
Rochester with a three-man rush.
Derrick, back to pass, looks right, throws right, incomplete. Vest had it at the 40, took his eyes off of it, looked it upfield before the ball went into his hands. Incomplete, third and 14 with a minute 10 to play in the game.
He might have looked up and saw Connor McLaughlin waiting for him right in front of him.
Yeah, it could have been. This game has been pretty physical.
Yeah.
Third and 14 for the Apaches. Five receivers again. Chase Derrick ready with 15 on the play clock. Takes a snap, high snap, pulls it down, looks to the middle. He's going to run. Derrick in the middle of the field, cuts back across the grain, still on his feet, has a first down. As he takes it inside the 45 down to the 41, that's going to be a first down for the Apaches of about 17 yards. A minute to play in the football game. Rochester up 14-0. And the Apaches looking to end this scoreless drought they've had against Rochester, now approaching 12 quarters. Derrick back to pass. Here comes the pressure. Steps up. He's going to keep it. Shakes one tackler. Sidesteps another one. He's at the 30. Down to around the 26. Clock stops with 52 seconds to play in the football game. Wabash is knocking on the door here.
Derrick approaching 100 yards rushing.
16-yard pickup for the quarterback. Clock rolls, under 50 to play in the game. Rochester up 14-0. Derrick out of the shotgun again. He looks right, steps up again. He's going to run again. Derrick is caught from behind and brought down to the 20.
McLaughlin on the tackle after Westbeck chased him out of the pocket.
Give him six, and Wabash will use their final timeout with 34 seconds to play in the game. Rochester leading 14-0. We'll take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. 34 seconds to play in the game. Wabash has the football, second and four from the Rochester 20. The Zebras leading 14-0, and this drive has been is Chase Derrick.
You're right.
That's what the whole game has been for Wabash,
yeah,
though,
yeah,
Chase
right.
Derrick.
Derrick in the shotgun. He's got five receivers, three to the right, two to the left. Quickly under center, or make that in the shotgun, throws it up in the back of the end zone. It is incomplete through the hands of two Rochester Zebra defenders, one being Bennett, the other being Hadashell in the end zone. It'll bring up fourth down and four.
His receiver was a little late. He out threw him, you know, was trying to lead him into the end zone on that one, and unfortunately, I think he threw it
third down
a little too far out in front of him.
Yeah, I'm sorry, third down and four for Wabash, the Rochester 20 with 29 seconds to play in the game. Third and four. Derek back to pass out of the shotgun. Looks left, throws left. It is tipped and tipped again. Falls to the ground. Harper tipped it the first time. Heckethorn the second time, and it goes to the ground. Fourth down and four.
I think if Heckethorn wanted that interception, I think he could have took it, but he just took both of his hands and swatted down at it, which I think is probably just as smart.
Fourth and four for the Apaches at the Rochester 20. Again, Rochester up 14 to nothing with 25 seconds to play in the game. Derrigan from the shotgun takes a snap. Looks right, looks in the middle, throws in the middle. He's got a receiver into triple coverage. It is incomplete. Rochester will take over on downs and line up in the victory formation. So the Rochester Zebras will take over on downs at their own 20-yard line. And all John Hunting will have to do is take a snap and take a knee, and Rochester will go to 2-1 and 1-0 in the TRC. Somehow.
Yeah, not a very impressive win for the Zebras. Probably one they won't talk much about.
Yeah, I would agree with that. Hunting takes the knee, and that'll do it. The final here from Rochester High School. The Zebras scored two late touchdowns to win this one 14 to nothing. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. Inside the 40 for Rochester. Here's a pitch to Beck. Beck with blockers in front. Beck runs over a tackler and it's a first down. He's still on his feet. Beck at the 20, the 15, the 10, the 5. Touchdown!